In this video, we're going to look at creating effects on the S-Play. The inbuilt effects and gradient engine mean you can take an S-Play to your project and program a 32 universe light show. This can contain animated gradient effects, pulses, static looks for wash lights, and chases for pixel tape, all without the need to record from a lighting desk or install any software on your computer. Just connect to its web interface and you're away. If you wanted to use the S-Play with moving lights for other complex fixtures, we'll add a link in the video description to static and dynamic hue creation. Before creating an effect, it's worth navigating to the S-Play settings page and ensuring your output settings are correct. For this video, I'm using three 8-segment RGB LED bars. This is plugged into one of the DMX outputs on the back of the S-Play. In the output settings, we can see the first two internal universes of the S-Play are set to send from the DMX ports. If you wanted to change all to a protocol at once, you could do it in the drop-down to the right-hand side. Once complete, we can press update and then head back to the cue library and press the plus icon to add a new effect. I'm going to call my new effect gradient, and to make it easier to see what's going on with my fixtures, I'll press preview. By default, the S-Play creates an effect that spans a full universe with the invert after X fixtures feature set to 0. As I've only got 24 RGB elements, I'll reduce this to 24. Right away, we can see the gradient snap to cover a tighter range of fixtures. If we had a grid of pixel tape wired in an S configuration, we could use the invert after every X fixtures option to make sure all gradient effects are lined up and kept in line top to bottom. Now, this worked for me right away because I'm using RGB fixtures starting on channel 1. But you may be using RGBW or GRB, just dimmers or another combination. For that reason, we've made sure to include a huge range of predefined colour orders, including 16-bit support for our Entek SmartPixel LED dots. DMX start address and the fixture offset between each new DMX address can be modified quickly. You can even use the offset option to create some cool-looking effects that you can layer with other cues that you've already created. Moving on, we can use the speed and direction slider to animate the gradient effect. I'll set this to 28, and then I'll select the blue toggle to change it to a more saturated colour. It's worth noting that you can set intensity waves by defining one of these as having no colour too. I'll slow this down and change the direction. By clicking on the gradient, we can add more colour stops. To make a smoother loop, we can set the colours at each end of the gradient to be the same. Down the bottom of the interface, we can see the S-Play's active internal universes that the effect occupies when running. We can toggle on as many universes as needed for our install. Anything that isn't toggled on won't get saved with the effect. If you want to spread the effect so it takes longer to run over your range of fixtures, simply increase the number of virtual fixtures the gradient occupies. Here I'll set 340. Instantly, you can see how the effect has been spread out in the real world. Given that the full effect size now spans two universes, the green boxes in the UI have expanded to indicate that to view the full cycle at once, two universes are needed. As ever, you can still modify any settings as you require. If I scroll down, you can see the full 340 fixtures and the active colours the S-Play has generated for this effect. When happy with this effect, we can press save. It can be previewed directly from the cue library or duplicated so you don't have to start from the beginning when it comes to creating another effect. If we head over to the playlist tab, We can see the gradient and its duplicate have populated already for us to drag into the timeline, alongside any other triggers, events, or cues you may have made. I'll drag this on, create a fade in and fade out time, and add the other effect too. After this, I'll give it a name, set it to start on power up, and press save. Now when pressing play, the playlist will start, the effect will fade in, and then loop infinitely. See our other videos and learn more about how to set up playlists, triggers, and schedules for the S-Play over at entech.com. And as ever, if you've got any questions, leave them in the comments below, or drop our team a message.